Hello, my name's Dylan, and welcome to Boost National Play Some Driver San Francisco. This, if we just get started, going to the free roam, this is one of my favourite games ever. Out of 10, I'd probably rate it a 9.5. There are very few things I find wrong with this. It's just a fantastic game. If we just wait for it to load. If you've never seen Driver San Francisco. Try saying that 10 times fast. San Francisco, it's kind of an awkward word. Actually, I guess it isn't too hard to say 10 times fast. Never mind. Right, so if you've never seen Driver San Francisco before, the entire plot of the game, this is sort of like a story-driven racing game. Basically, at the beginning of the game, you get put into a coma. And you're in like a kind of dream. So you basically, you have this superpower, almost, to be able to go into anybody's body and drive their car. Can't do it to random people on the, just walking around, but you know, we'll just ignore that slight plot inconsistency. I think it probably would have hindered the game, if anything, trying to force in sort of running sections. But yeah, you can just jump into any car. You also have a Ram, if I show you. Hit this Audi. Didn't take any damage from that, and you basically get a massive boost of acceleration. Watch the speedometer. But yeah, see, I do 143 miles an hour almost instantly, and then I come to a halt. You also have a boost. You have your boost and basic nitrous, recharges over time fairly quickly. The other thing though about this game is the fact that every car in this game, bit of police tab, it's the new drifting move, police tab, like a wall tap, only you scrape the side of a police car. All the cool kids are doing it, what was I saying? Something along the lines of, never mind. I like to talk about, handling's, quite fun. One of the best handling systems in game history, actually. One of the reasons I like it so much is, well, it's good especially for this game where you can take any car. What about 240Z up there? Yeah, it is. One of the best handling systems of all time. Every car in this game is fun to drive, and I'll prove it to you. Probably should have I'll just drive away from that. Yeah, you can just leave chases like that. And but I'm in this big fuel tanker, right? You'd expect this to be kind of dull to drive, kind of heavy. Nope, not in this game. This makes the drifters in Forza that have the S15s and whatnot. This can do way better skids, drifts, whatever. It's handbrake. But yeah, everything in this game is fun to drive, which is great because it doesn't matter whatever car you switch into, you're guaranteed to have something that's at least drivable. It's what works. About this game. There's 140 cars in this game. So if we head to this garage, 140 cars. I've got all of them at the moment, but there are all these couple of interesting things like the buggy. Really isn't enough off-road to really use that. Is also right. So every car you see driving around, you can buy. So you can even buy stuff like the garbage trucks, as you can see here. Along with in the garage, there are upgrades. You have increased the ability bar, recharge speed, token finder, which is I'll show you that in a second. Income multiplier. Every 20 minutes, you get some income based on the upgrade of this and. How many cars you own. So buying cars is actually a good way to earn money. as bizarre as that thing, and Field Cam. I'll show you that in a minute as well. So the Token Finder, that's for the movie. Just the movie challenges. You see those blue hexagons in the corner of every picture? Those are, you find those around in the world. You probably saw like some blue dots on the map that's at the top of the screen. If you look on the map, the ones that are moving are police cars on the map. And there's no stationary ones. And here we go. So, by here. There you go. Yeah, these are, you need to find those to unlock movie challenges. A couple of things that I find annoying about this game. Police chases, to start off with, you need to give police cars a bit of a whack sometimes to get them to chase you. Sometimes you need to really ram into them to get them to chase you, which is a shame because there's a movie editor in this where you can set the camera angles and stuff, which is quite cool. And, sometimes when you try and film a dramatic at police chase, you can't just speed past a police car. It turns on its lights and then starts chasing you. You need to ram into the back of it or whatever. It's sort of a minor thing, but I think it'd be kind of cool if you can just sort of speed past them or, crash into another car next to them. Or just other ways to start police chases, but that's more of a problem just for me. Alright, no. I've got a better car, actually. There are a couple of rally cars in this. This is one of the more fun cars to drive. Other problems I have with it, you can't pick what colour your car is. So, it can be, it's just randomised out of a selection of colours, which is a shame. Also, some of the convertibles, you can't choose whether roofs are up or down. There is interior view, though, for all cars, which is quite nice. There's also this thrill cam. This is the thrill cam. It's sort of just, crash into things because you can't see where you're going. Other problem is the AI is basically on rails. So, if I show you something, you can do a Fast and Furious. Wait. If he didn't turn there, or if he slowed down a bit, that could have looked really cool. This game's great for making you look like a god at driving. But yeah, all the AI's on rails, meaning when you get to stuff like this, they'll eventually just drive in loops, like this truck by here, and the and a Dodge. It's just gonna keep going around in loops around this block. I'm going around block. No, what is a block? Americans, please explain. They'll keep going around that, which can sometimes make it feel too easy to avoid traffic when they're not changing lanes or anything. In some ways, it's good. Again, making you seem like a better driver than you actually are, but to me, it kind of takes away from being the world being immersive and stuff. I just kind of want this to be. I feel like this should be. This game could have been focused on being just making cool car chases and stuff, and kind of the AI and stuff. But other than those sort of minor problems, there's also one more problem I have. Zooming between the highest and zooming in and out between the highest mode of zoom when you're in shift mode, that takes a couple of seconds, which can be annoying. Those are my minor problems. Everything else is pretty good. The storyline in this, something at least. I mean, I don't think it's awful. Quick shift, which is quite cool. You can also do that, but when you're in police chases, if there's another police car in the chase with you, if I can get a police car now, you can change between the two yeah, the two people, the two cows in a chase or whatever. Don't know why that took me so long to say. I'm mixing up my words today. What else was I going to say? Yeah, the storyline in this game, I mean, I don't think it's awful, but I couldn't really care less about writing and stuff. If it makes me laugh occasionally, or, you know, has a plot without plot holes in it, you never go, why can't they do that? It's kind of funny, actually, because you unlock the game area. If I show you now, you can sort of quick shift, I think it's called rapid shift, even, it's called. So that, it's quite cool. It's all about just keeping the chase up. We're in the exact same car. Actually, I think this one's faster. How is he getting away? Here we go. Yeah, he'll wreck now. Yeah, anyway, story, it's okay. Yeah, you unlock, because you unlock the world, more of the world, so, like, parts get locked off at the beginning, and you, unlock more of the world, they actually, in some of the cutscenes, they actually, show that, where, yeah, would have thought that would have wrecked him. Try it. Yeah, just another. Use the boost. No, come on. I do find it kind of weird how there's like a 10-second rule or whatever, but you know. That's kind of weird. What else is there? I don't know. This game's just really good. Go and buy it. No. I'm probably not doing this game enough justice. Expect there to be more plays some. That was kind of weird to say, but it's the series name. Wait, no. Shift like that. It's kind of hard to get used to doing that. Clip. And boom. Yeah, his rear wheel just flies off because of that. Oh yeah, there are also random chases, which is, yeah, that's quite cool. Just occasionally, and you can actually choose which side, so do you want to get in the getaway car, or do you want to get in the police car, so you can actually choose. We'll get in the getaway car. No. Yeah. That was a weird slide. They were just holding in an angle, and they're just kind of weird. Normally, you start moving forward. Oh, what's Julia? Was it Alpha Spider, or isn't it called Julia? Never mind. I don't know much about 60s European cars. I know the E-Type existed, the 300 SL existed, and that's about it. Also, it is. There's never a point where it's impossible to escape the police. There'll eventually be a point where they just stop spawning police cars. So if you just wreck all the police cars chasing you, you can get away. Which is good in a way, but at the same time, I don't know, it's kind of cool how you can guaranteed get away. Oh, it is actually possible. To get away in even something like a Volkswagen camper van. Surprised didn't hook onto that tow truck. You can hook onto tow trucks and stuff. You know what, to end this out, we're going to do sort of a mission that's the final mission in the game, special. Yes, there's this, which is first mission of the original Driver. You unlock it by getting 88 miles an hour in DeLorean, and then there's this, which is difficult. Well, I've one quick go at this, as I kind of want to keep these videos semi-short, whatever. Yeah, I set a personal record yesterday. I'm going to drive like this, because I want to kind of do it semi-seriously. Yeah, I set a new record of 1 minute 49 yesterday. That kind of goes to show how difficult this challenge is. I'm physically ducking. Oh my gosh, could you imagine this in HTC Vive? You know, VR, just... Oh my god, that would be... That'd actually be scary. Also, one thing you want to do, don't get hit at all. If you don't get hit in the first place, then you should be okay. Once you get hit, or once you slow down, you're a sitting target and you can just pelt cars at you. Survive a minute at minimum, I think, for you to get money. Not sure, though. Dodge the Corvette. Actually, that's made of fiberglass anyway, isn't it? Should be okay. You can't catch up to the guy you're chasing either. The final mission involves you flinging cars back at him as well, but the only problem is you can fling the cars that he's thrown at you back at him, so you can kind of just, he can never get a hit on you when you're throwing the cars at him, which is kind of a shame how the game gets kind of unbalanced like that. Right, I'm going to slow down a bit because that was a bad idea. Probably shouldn't press on right. Oh gosh, I'm blind. Oh, I'm about to wreck. Oh wait, can I? Yep, wrecked. Yeah, this is, alright, you need to survive a minute for the first time. Now, this is, it's a difficult mission. Don't expect to survive much. Anyway, this has, if you've enjoyed, don't forget to leave a like and subscribe. Goodbye.